Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the topic, that is microencapsulation. So first of all, we have to see what is microencapsulation. So it's a process or technique in which relatively thin coating that can be applied to the small solid particles or droplet of the liquids or liquid dispersion. Also we can call it as a process by which very tiny droplets or particles of liquid or solid materials are surrounded or coated with the continuous film of polymeric materials. Also, we can call this a process of the surrounding or enveloping one substance with the another substance on a very small scale that yield the capsules ranging from less than 1 microns to the several hundred micron in the size. So that also we can call as a microencapsulation process. So here the two parts are there, core material and the coating materials are there. The product obtained by this process that we can call as a microparticles, microcapsule, microspheres. So there are the synonyms of that parts. So in that we have to apply in the thin coating to the small particles of the solid or liquid droplets. So the microsphere and microcapsules, two terminologies are there. So their particle size around 50 to 5000 micron size are there. So if particles having less than 1000, in between 3 to 800 micrometers, so we can generally known as a microparticle, microcapsule or microspheres. If more than 1000 are there, micrometer size, larger particles, so either macroparticles are there. So here microcapsules and microsphere, two terminology we have to use. So in that, so microcapsules, so in that there are active agents, active drugs that forms a core surrounded by the inner diffusion layer. So that is the capsule, microcapsule. So in that, in the core portion, drug, active drug is there that surrounded by the diffusive barrier layer, polymeric membrane or polymeric layer. In microsphere, the active agent is dispersed or dissolved uniformly into that inert polymer. So that is microsphere. So here given some different structure of that microsphere: mononuclear, multinuclear, spherical, irregular, like that, encapsulated microcapsules, dual wall microcapsules, like that. So this is the typical structure of the microcapsules. The next, that is the advantage of the microencapsulations. Why we have to go for the that preparation of microencapsulation or microsphere or microparticles? So the main thing that is to increase the bioavailability or to alter the drug release, ultimately to improve the patient compliance, to produce the targeted or site-specific drug system that we have to apply with that microencapsulation concept, to reduce the reactivity of the core in relation to the outside environment. It decreases the evaporation rate of the core materials. It converts liquid to solid form and to mask the core test, the test maskings are there, improve the stability parts are there. So these are the some advantages of the microencapsulation. So there some disadvantages are also there for the microencapsulation. So several formulations from that it is very difficulties are there. Then the we can say that no single microencapsulation process that is adaptable for all the core materials, core the drugs. So cross reaction between the core and cell materials are there. Incomplete or discontinuous coatings may be occur. So we have to require the specific expert or persons for the coating, said that the problems we have to counter it, that incomplete or discontinuous the coating part. Difficult to achieve the continuous and uniform fill. So similar like that, we have to see the coating is not properly done throughout that. Sometimes failure to produce the predict release rate. So the fluctuation may be first effect sometimes. So that also the disadvantage, but economically that we have to see the limitations. So the cost, production cost, that we have to compare with the conventional tablet capsules. So it may be higher. So more skill, knowledge, expertise persons that require. So these are some disadvantages that we have to consider for the micro encapsulation. The next, the general composition, general formation of fundamental that considers. So generally that micro encapsulant or micro particles that consist of two components, that core materials and the coating materials are there. So the core materials mainly our active drugs, active constituents. The solid core can be a mixture of drug, other than drugs, stabilizers, that we have to add diluents, excipients, other excipient. If the drug is in liquid, so that is the dispersed or dissolved materials are there. In coating materials, that we have to go for the water soluble resin, water insoluble resin, wax materials are there, enteric resin. So these are some examples are there for the coating, that we have to go for gelatin, PVP, ethyl cellulose, Celec, like that. So many examples are there for the coating materials, and we have to use the vehicles, that aqueous or non-aqueous, anyone that we have to use. So the core materials that already we have to see, that specific material that we have to go for the coating. So it may be liquid in nature or solid in natures. The compositions already we have to see, the drugs, additives like diluent, stabilizers, release rate, enhancer or retardant, that materials that we have to use. In coating materials, they have to should be desired some capability, that criteria that we have to require, that we have to see the properties. So the stabilization part, so it stabilize the core material, protection base like that, inert towards active ingredients. So chemically inert substance, not going for interaction with that part. Control release under specific conditions, so we have to achieve that control release part. Film forming, tasteless, stable, non-hygroscopic nature, non-high viscosity, economically based, soluble in aqueous media or the solvents. And the coating can be flexible, that we have to go brittle, hard, thin, add extra. So like that, the properties, the compatibility, non-reactivity, that we have to see, the flexibility, non-hygroscopicity, tasteless, stable. So like that, the criteria we have to require for the core materials. The polymer that we have to use, release retardant, release enhancer, like that, the polymer coating. So that is the major role of that in that micro encapsulants or any sustained control release system or site specific targeted release system. So polymer take the most important role in that part. So polymer already we have to know, that the substance of high molecular weight that is made up of repeating monomer units by the process of polymerizations. So polymers molecules already we have, so then may be classified like linear branch like that, and that widely used as adjuvant coating material for the control and the site specific drug delivery system. The release mechanisms from that polymer that we have to use coating materials, from that how the drug will release. So there are mechanisms are there. So in that, the diffusion control, monolithic and reservoir. So diffusion control matrix and encapsulation type. Dissolution base are there, degradation, erosions are there. Generally, the diffusion base mechanisms that widely we, that follow for the drug release from that part. The next one, that is the method or the techniques that use for the development, preparation or manufacturing of that micro encapsulation. So here two methods are there, physical and the chemical methods. The physicals in that air suspension coating, coagulation or phase separation process, the pan coating, spray drying, spray conjuring, in the chemical process, solvent evaporation, polymerizations. So like that, the technique that used for the development of micro encapsulation. We have to see one by one. So first the air suspension techniques, also called the Wurster process, also that invention by that professor Tally Wurster. So basically the Wurster process that consists of the dispersing of the solid, the core materials, our API drugs, particularly our core materials in supporting into the airstream like fluidized air dryers, so that they go for in airstreams, and the spray coating of the air suspended particles, so that the core materials that go for the airstreams, and on that we have to spray out our coating materials into that air suspended particles. So the equipment that ranging the capacity from 1 pound to around 1,000 pounds, like that micron or sub micron type of particles, which can be effectively encapsulated by the air suspension techniques. So within the coating chambers that we have to see, so particles are suspended on the upward moving airstream from the below, from bottom the spray nozzles are there, so that the our core materials that suspended into the airstream, upward movements are there moving to the airstream. So the design of the chamber and their operating parameters that affecting the recalculating flow of that air particles through the coating zone portions of the chambers, so where coating materials, usually the polymeric solutions are there, that we have to spread, apply to that moving particles or the core materials are there. So generally we can say that the Wurster process, so this is a technology that is characterized by the location of that spray nozzles at the bottom, that in the fluidized air dryer already we have to know that the solid particles for the drying part. So the particles are suspended into the fluidized state, fluidized airstream in the air suspended. So that is designed to induce a cyclic flow on the particles that pass with the spray nozzles. The nozzle sprays is an atomized flow of the coating solution, suspension, other coating vehicles. So the technology can be used to encapsulate the solid materials with the diameter ranging from nearer to 15 micrometer to several microns, like that. So that process widely we can use for encapsulating the vitamins, minerals, the various functional food ingredients. So here from the bottom spray nozzles are there, the our coating materials that go for the airstream suspended. In the top part spray nozzles are there, they spray out the coating materials are there. So here the process that we can call the air suspension process, that is offer wide variety for the coating of variety of material candidates for the encapsulation part. So it consists of dispersing the solid core material in the supporting air streams and being coated with the polymeric solution or coating material solution. So in that part the fine core materials are suspended in a vertical current air from the bottom and spray with the coating materials. After that the evaporation of that solvent, a layer of encapsulating material is deposited on the core part, core materials, the layer of the coating solution, that film created after the evaporation of the solvent. So it gives the improve the quality and flexibility that is compared with the pan coating methods. So during each pass through the coating zone, the core material receive the increments of coating materials, like that. So it's a cyclic process that go for the repetitions. So perhaps several hundred times that we can call during the processing, depending upon the purpose of our micro encapsulation, that coating thickness that we would require, desire, whether the core materials particles we would require, which size and the thickness of that coating materials are there. Supporting the air streams also serve for the go for the drying to the product while it is being encapsulated. So drying rate are directly related to the volume temperature of the supporting air stream. So the disadvantages that we have to see with the air suspension technique or the Wurster process, that is the agglomeration of the particles to some case that becomes a larger macro size that we have to achieve normally. Another that is go for the centrifugal extrusion process are also there. So in that the liquids are encapsulated using the rotating extrusion that head containing a concentric nozzles. That process is excellent for forming the particles around 400 to approximately 2000 micrometer in the diameter. So the drops are formed by this breakup of that liquid jet. The process is only suitable for liquid and the slurry, highly thick liquid preparations are there. Viscous. So a high production rate can be achieved by that process, centrifugal extrusion. The next one, which is widely used for the micro encapsulation process, that is coeservation method or the phase separations method that we have to call. So the coeservations is a phase also called the phase separation of one or many hydrochlorides that form initial solution, and then the subsequent depositions of that newly formed coeservate phase around that active drugs or drugs that suspended or emulsify in the that same reaction media. So that process typically used for the encapsulations of flavoring oils, nutrient, vitamin, preservatives, like that preparations are there. Generally two type of that coeservations are then that available, that is namely simple coeservation process or the complex are there. So the mechanism of that microcapsule formulation for both the process is identical, except for the way in which the phase separation is going for or carried out. So a desolvation agent is added for the phase separations in the simple parts are there. In complex coeservation, that involves the complexations between the two oppositely charged polymers. So like that the things are there in simple and the complex process are there that we have to know. Then so in the general process that we have to consider for the coeservation or phase separation methods, so the three steps are there. So first one, that is formation of three immiscible chemical phase or three immiscible phase. Second one, the deposition of the coating. And the third one, that is the rigidization of the coating. So the three immiscible phase that we have to say that the step one. So in that the liquid manufacturing vehicle phase, aqueous non-aqueous phase, the vehicle phase, core material phase and the coating material phase. So three immiscible phases are there. So the coating material phase, that is formed by the utilization of any method, that is temperature change, addition of incompatible polymer, non-solvent addition, solvent addition, polypolymer interactions like that. So we have to get that coating material phase like that. In step 2, so the depositions of the coating material or liquid polymers, polymeric solutions are there around the interface that is formed between the core material and the liquid vehicle phase. So there the deposition of that our coating materials are there. So in many cases, physical chemical changes in the coating polymer solution can be induced so that phase separation of that polymer will occurs. Then the finally the third, the prepared micro encapsulations are stabilized by one of the methods we would go for cross-linking, desolvation, removal of solvents or the thermal treatment, the heat temperature that we have to give. So the equipment that is required for the micro encapsulation, this method is relatively simple. It consists mainly of jacket tank with variable speed agitators that we have to use. So that is the coeservation phase separation techniques for that. The complex parts are also there. So here the oil with gelatin solution examples are given, matrix materials are there. During the optional insert of that for the encapsulant mixings are there. Then we have to go for the cross linking, adjust the pH, the temperature changes, go for the washing set, isolated microcapsules that we have to get by the coeservation or phase separation method. The next one, that is the PAN coatings, that we have to go for simple coating like that. So it is the oldest industrial procedure methods that is used for small scale, like the small coated particles or the tablet coating. That time we have to go for the PAN coatings. So the particles that are tumble in the pan, so you have to go for tumbling rotation at specific angle. You have to rotate that tumbles on the other device while the coating materials is applied slowly. So we have to, with the spray gun nosing, we have to spread out our polymeric solutions. So air atomizing nozzle spray zones are there that we have to spread out our coating materials, polymeric solution, to the tumbling pan, in which that we have to put our particles, small particles, tablets, like that. So that is our general coating methods are there. We have to use the blower, that hot air streams that go for the drying purpose. So solid particles that greater than the 600 micron in size are generally considered essentially for the effective. So some large particle size that we require. So medicaments are usually that go for coating with the various spherical substrates, non-ferrous sugar seeds, then coated with protective layer of various polymers. So like that things are there. They're used for generally for the control release beads. The coating that is applied as a solution by the atomized spray, with that we have to see the air atomizing nozzle spray zones are there to desired solid core material into the coating pump. Then usually warm air or hot air, the blower, that we have to see that cold air is passed over the coating materials, that coated materials, as the coating are being applied in the coating part. So solid particles are mixed with the dry coating materials, temperature is rise, so that the coating materials that go for melts and close the core particles and then solidify by the cooling. So the same things are there. So simple process are there that we have to know. Once again, we have to see the coating materials that can be gradually applied slowly, that we have to apply to the core particles, our drug or materials, the particles which are tumbling in that pan or vessels, rather than being only mixed with the core particles from the start of the encapsulation. So that we have to slowly apply with that air atomizing or spray nozzles. So the particles are tumble in the pan or other device while the coating material is applied slowly. So the coating is applied as a solution or as an atomized spray to the desired solid core materials in the coating pan. So spray gun, nozzle guns are also there that you so usually the remove of that solvent, dissolution, the coating solvents, so warm air, hot air that we have to pass over the coated material as a coating are being applied in the coating pan. So in some case, if that not, you have to give the hot air or warm air. So final solvent removal is accomplished in the oven or drying process that you have to go on for the hot air oven also. So next one, that is the spray drying or spray congealing are the spray drying. So the coating, that solidification affected by the rapid evaporating of that solvent in which coating material is dissolved, and the spray congealing. So that coating solidification is affected by the thermally congealing or molten coating materials. The removal of solvent is done by the absorption, extraction, or any evaporation techniques that we have to use. So spray drying, spray congealing. So spray drying is affected by rapid evaporation of the solvent, that we have to know that. So equipment that is used, air heater, atomizer, main spray chamber, blower, fan, cyclone, product collector, like that, the things that we have to require in a spray dryer parts. So the heater, nozzle, drying chamber, then cyclone separator, temperature sensor, like that, the filter, collecting product collector, like that. So the in micro encapsulation by spray drying is a low cost commercial process which is most widely used for the encapsulation of fragrance, oil, flavors, like that. So the core particles are dispersed in a polymeric solution and spray into the drying chamber or hot chamber. So the air are there, heaters are there, nozzles are there, from that the sample that go for the spread out into the hot chamber, drying chamber. The cell materials solidify into the core particle as the solvents evaporate, so that microcapsule obtained by the polynucleometric step. So there is a spray drying concept, drying part. In spray congealing, that already see that complies with the spray drying equipment when the protective coating is applied as a melt. So the core material is dispersed into the coating material that melt rather than the coating solution. So here that is difference. So coating solidification is accomplished by the spraying the hot mixture into the cool air streams. So that examples is used for the microencapsulation of vitamins with the digestive wax for the taste masking. So like that the process are there for that. The next that is the chemical process. So in that the solvent evaporations are there. So that we have to see that core materials are there, that we have to dissolve the drug plus polymers, organic solvents are there, that the coating polymeric solutions in that part with agitations. So into additive into the aqueous phase the vehicle, then you have to go for heating. So that evaporations of that phase polymeric solvents, then recovery of that micro encapsulation particles. Lastly, with that we have to see with the solvent evaporation. So in that solvent evaporations, that we have to see the core materials that we have to disperse in the polymeric solution, that is polymer shrink around the core. So in this case, in which core materials that is dissolves in the coating polymer solution matrix and micro encapsulation that we have to form. So that core materials may be either water soluble, water insoluble polymers, variety of film forming polymers that can be used for the coating by the solvent evaporation. The generally three steps are there. First, the formation of the solution or dispersion of drug into organic polymeric phase, emulsification of that polymeric phase into aqueous phase that containing suitable stabilizers, that forming all water emulsion. And then the last step, the removal of that organic solvent from the dispersed phase by the extraction or evaporations to precipitate out that polymer and formation of that micro particles, microsphere, micro encapsulation like that. The second chemical process method, that is the polymerization process. So in that method, that involves the reaction of that monomeric unit plus that we have to see the cross-linking polymers are there, like the monomers are there. So that unit located at the interface that existing between a core material substance and a continuous phase in which core material is going for the disperse. So that core materials supporting phase is usually a liquid or gas, and therefore polymerization reaction occurs at liquid also, liquid gas, solid-liquid, solid gas, anyway. Example for that, so the formation of polyamides, polymeric reactions that occurs at liquid-liquid interface that existing between the aliphatic diamine, dicarboxylic acid, halides like that. So that is the polymerizations are the monomers, cross-linking plus drugs are the preparation of polymerizing mixtures, addition of that alcoholic solution for the initiator, so initiation of that polymerization process. After the reaction time, monodispersed latex formations by the polymer precipitations. After that, lastly that we have to recover the polymeric microparticles are there. So in that polymerizations, there may be a interfacial polymerization, in situ polymerization, matrix polymerization. So interfacial polymerization in that, so the two reactants in a polycondensation that meet at the interface and that react rapidly, so that is interfacial. In situ polymerization, so in few micro encapsulation process, that is go for the direct polymerization of single monomers is carried out on the particle surface. So in the cellulose fibers that go for the encapsulation, that is examples for the polyethylene. Then matrix polymers, in that number of process the core material is embedded in that polymer matrix during the formation of particles. Any one interfacial polymer in situ or matrix polymerization are there. Then next, that is the evolution part of the micro encapsulation, that characterization part that we have to see. So these are the some evolution parameter tests are there for the micro encapsulation. Then we have to go for the morphology, that the shape of that micro particles or microspheres. So we have to go for microscopic methods. So optical microscope, so that we have to use to diagnose the shape of that microparticles or microsphere. Sorry. So that shape, their surface morphology, that is studied by the scanning electron microscopy, that we have to go for SEM or TEM. So it gives the idea regarding the surface before the coating and the after the coating. So it also helps determining the uniformity and the nature of that coating. That's we have to go for polymeric coating, that parts. So we have to go for the morphology, drug content. So in that microcapsules, so randomly we have to select the batch. Then we have to dissolve in specific dissolution media for specific quantity, that filter it out with a Wattmann filter like that. Then that solutions we have to dilute and analyze using any sophisticated analytical method, UV-HPLC, and we have to find out the concentration, the drug content that is present in that micro capsules or microparticles. Like that encapsulation efficiency, that we have to find out in particular microparticles capsules, how much drugs for encapsulated entrapments are there, percentage yield. Then like preformation parameters like bulk density, angle of repose, that we have to find out up, and that the particle size determinations are there. So particle size, we have to go for zeta sizes, we have to determine the particle size in micron or nano size also, that we have to go for the zeta size or particle size we have to find out. Then the major important part, that is in vitro dissolution drug release. So you have to use the dissolution apparatus for that, and you have to find out the drug release part. Then the stability, so that go for the ICH guidelines. As per the ICH guidelines, we have to go for the short term, long term, or accelerated stability studies. So in that 25 degree Celsius temperature, so relative humidity is 55. If we increase the temperature 30 degrees Celsius, 60% relative humidity is higher than 40 degrees Celsius. So go for the 70% relative humidity. So that accelerated, we have to go for 3 to 6 months. Long terms, we have to require for 1 to 2 years. So that stability studies, we have to go for it. That we have to find out the assay. So that assay of the microcapsules or microencapsulation is carried out by dissolving specific weight of that microcapsules in that organic solvent like methanol or any other suitable solvent where the solvent, we have to filter it out. We have to appropriate method to estimate the drug content that carried out with several batches variation that we have to find out. So these are the, some evaluation test or parameters for the microencapsulation. The next one, that is the applications of the microencapsulation. So generally that you we have to go for that improve the flow properties of the material of the particles or drugs, that's the vitamins, the examples are there. It provides the protection to the, our core materials. So that's why with the, we have to go for the encapsulation part. So it protected from the environmental condition. So it enhances the stability of that fat soluble vitamins are there. Prevent the incompatibility between the drugs. So that is also incompatible drugs are there in the combination. So we have to go for the encapsulation of the drug. Test masking, it is also one of the applications are there. We have to use the mask of that unpleasant taste of the drugs, because most of the drugs are mostly bitter in taste. So we have to go for the masking of that part. Reduce the gastric irritations parts are there, that protect with that the local irritation in the GI tract, upper part of the GI tract stomachs. Production of sustained release dosage from sustained control, specific targeted part that we have to achieve by the applying that microencapsulation concept. Reduce the hazard possibility, reduce the possibility of sensitizations like that. So many applications are there in point of view with pharmaceutical fields or in the drug release system or dosage forms that we have to go for sustained control. So that's why we had one of the approaches for the novel drug release system, that is microencapsulation. Here some examples are there for the marketed formulations are there, the brand name, the generic name, that aspirin drugs are there. Glipizide drugs that available in, go for the microencapsulation. Cefotaxil, like the antibiotics are there. So that we have to summarize, conclude that we have to see the micro encapsulation. It is one of the in the novel degree system part. The micro encapsulation, what is the micro encapsulation? What is their advantages, disadvantages are there? General formulations for the micro encapsulations, the various methods that you use for the preparation or development of micro encapsulation, evaluation parameters of that micro encapsulation, and then lastly that we have to see the applications of the micro encapsulation process. Thank you.